in a illegal occupation, violence and racial segregation, all religious communities unite.
I just would like to show my support to this campaign and condemn the collaboration between the German government and the Israeli state. I believe that this is not a religious war and this is just political conflict, and they are trying to all these supports between the European countries and the Israeli state are doing nothing except maintaining this war and maintaining the blood and maintaining the oppression of the Palestinian. So I'm showing my support to the Palestinian people. I'm showing my support to this campaign and I should support too. Thanks.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thanks.
A blinding flash of white light lit up the sky over Gaza tonight. People running for cover, not knowing whether they're dead or alive. They came with their tanks and their planes, ravaging fiery flames. Nothing remains, just the voice rising up in the smoky haze. We will not go down in the night without a fight. You can burn up our mosques and our homes and our schools, but our spirit will never die.
Tomorrow will be free.
say no. Thank you.
Freedom for Palestine, freedom for Gaza, freedom for every child, mother and father. While being born in the arms of Obama, I'm bursting out tears while you're bursting out with laughter. Freedom for Palestine, freedom for Gaza, freedom for every child, mother and father. It's a crazy routine, guys, why? But they're killing newborn babies. Freedom won't be achieved until they feel the same pain. Palestinian shower tears pouring down like rain. Every bird is a planet. On a hunger strike, never charged, never tried by the damn boy.
For justice in Palestine.
We will not go there.
Today, the German government is shamefully celebrating 50 years of collaboration with the racist apartheid regime. As part of this celebration of ethnic cleansing, occupation and war crimes, the German Deputy Ambassador and the Israeli Deputy Ambassador are hosting a reception at the Goethe Institute to launch the Israeli government-sponsored Seret 2015 Film Festival. We are here outside the Goethe Institute to tell the German Deputy Ambassador to stop pandering to a regime whose Deputy Defense Minister has threatened the people of Gaza with a Holocaust. A regime whose siege of Gaza has been compared to the Nazi siege of the Warsaw Ghetto by the United Nations Human Rights Rapporteur. A regime whose genocide in Gaza has been unequivocally condemned by more than 300 survivors of the Nazi Holocaust. We ask the Deputy Ambassador to learn from Germany's past and stop supporting a fascist, racist regime, to stop arming Israel with nuclear submarines, and to stop helping Israel whitewash its crimes behind a veneer of culture. The Israeli government, through its London embassy, is sponsoring the Israeli Film Festival, Seret 2015, as the latest chapter of Israel's million-dollar brand Israel PR campaign, whereby culture is used to whitewash an apartheid state founded on the ethnic cleansing of the Palestinian people and occupation of their land. Goethe Institute, stop your complicity with apartheid! It was wrong in South Africa, and it's wrong today in Palestine. Stop hosting apartheid. Stand on the right side of history. Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
This is the letter that has come out in the Guardian newspaper yesterday. We, the below-listed artists, producers, and concerned citizens, are disappointed and saddened to see that Curzon, Odeon, BAFTA and other cinemas are hosting the London Israeli Film and Television Festival. This comes at a time when the global boycott, divestment and sanctions, BDS movement, against Israel is gaining unprecedented momentum, and the Israeli government is finding itself increasingly isolated for its systematic violation of Palestinian human rights, the Geneva Conventions, and international law. The Israeli state is promoting this festival and supporting it financially. By hosting it, these cinemas are ignoring the 2004 call by Palestinian civil society for sanctions against Israel until Israel abides by international law and ends its illegal displacement of Palestinians, discrimination against them, and occupation of their land. By benefiting from money from the Israeli state, the cinemas become silent accomplices to the violence inflicted on the Palestinian people. Such collaboration and cooperation is unacceptable. We call upon these cinemas to stand with the oppressed Palestinian people and to take no part in presenting this festival.
Sheikh Khader Adnan is known as the father of the hunger strike, the symbol of Palestinian resistance and steadfastness. In 2011, he was abducted and caged indefinitely without any charge or trial under Israeli illegal system of punitive administrative detention. To protest his illegal imprisonment, he went on a hunger strike and won his freedom. His successful 60-day hunger strike in 2012, the longest in Palestinian history at the time, inspired over 1,600 other Palestinian prisoners to hunger strike. Since his release, Sheikh Khader Adnan has been the voice of the Palestinian political prisoners, ceaselessly defending their rights at every opportunity, and thus is a thorn in the side of the occupation. He has been in and out of occupation prisons since his student days from 1999 due to his political stance against the occupation. He has spent more than 6 years of his life caged in occupation dungeons, yet he has never been formally charged with anything, let alone stand trial for anything. Sheikh Khader Adnan is the father of 6 children. Youngest are triplets under 2 years old, Ali, Hamza, and Muhammad. His other son is age 3, Abdurrahman. His 2 daughters are Mali, the eldest is just 7 years old, and Bisan, 5 years old. Khader Adnan has a degree in mathematics and runs a bakery in the town of Araba, near Jenin, in the West Bank. His wife, Renda, describes their marriage as a partnership. Khader is not just my husband, she says. He is a partner in struggle. I have been with him to protests, and together we support prisoners' families. I never considered this a burden or an exhaustion, but rather an asset. She stresses how loving and gentle Adnan is. He always helped me look after the children, changing their diapers and doing stuff that other men never considered doing. During my pregnancy with triplets, Khader was the one cleaning the house and making every effort to keep me happy and comfortable. On Tuesday the 8th of July 2014, he was returning home to share the iftar meal with his family after the Ramadan fast when he was abducted at a temporary checkpoint the occupation had illegally set up near his hometown. He was given a 6-month administrative detention order without charge or trial. When the occupation renewed the order in January 2015 with an additional 4 months administrative detention order, Sheikh Khader Adnan protested by going on a 1-week hunger strike, announcing beforehand the duration of the strike. And when that administrative detention finished, and they again gave him another 6 months administrative detention order in May 2015, Sheikh Khader Adnan started his open-ended hunger strike on the 6th of May 2015. It must be noted that Khader Adnan's hunger strike is complete. Unlike many previous long-term hunger strikers, he is refusing vitamins and other nutritional supplements so he cannot stay alive long.
Reports suggest that on day 35 of his hunger strike, he is already experiencing intermittent comas, a sharp decrease in weight, and a drop in his heart rate. His mother says that we discussed the issue before he was arrested again in July last year. I told him, please, if they arrest you again, don't go on a hunger strike. He remained silent, but gave me a look that pierced my heart like a bullet, as if to ask me to respect his decision and not expect me to deprive him of the only weapon he would have. Khader Adnan informed his wife and his father of his plan to go on a hunger strike in case Israeli authorities were to renew his administrative detention. His father explains, Khader is not a nihilist. He's not doing this because he wants to die and because he wants to hurt himself. On the contrary, he is going through this because he loves life and believes that this is the only way to achieve freedom. This is Khader Adnan's message from the 4th of June, 2015, day 30 of hunger strike. From the bottom of my heart, I express my gratitude for your support and your solidarity. May Allah restore the freedom so that we can rejoin our families soon. The Israeli jailers tried to break us down, but we promise them with Allah's help and support and your solidarity that we will win, inshallah. This hunger strike continues until we win our freedom, inshallah. Freedom for Khalid Adnan! Freedom for all Palestinian political prisoners! Freedom for Palestine!
On July 2nd, 2014, in the early hours, a Palestinian boy of 16 years old was kidnapped, brutally beaten, and set alive on fire by six illegal settlers on the street of Jerusalem. Those illegal settlers have not been yet brought to justice. Their trial still continues a year later. This month, Mohammed Abu Qadir would have graduated from high school. He was only 16 and he was burned alive.